What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. Today, we got a couple of small projects to do on the C4, so let's go ahead and take a look. First project is we're going to be replacing the target top latch in the rear hatch area. So let's go ahead and pop the hatch and take a look. All right, so come around to the center here. As you can see, the little handle has broken off there. So it's pretty common for people to lose this part. But the bad part about mine is the piece that actually sticks onto is broken as well. So we're going to go ahead and replace the whole thing. I found this on eBay. I think it was about 40 bucks, which is pretty expensive for a piece of plastic, to be honest, but it is what it is. So I think what we got to do is we got a series of screws in this plastic shroud. I believe that comes right off and we can get in there to get a couple of screws off of this piece and put the new one in. All right, so we got our Phillips screwdriver. I would suggest getting a magnetic bowl as well to place all of your hardware in. So let's go ahead and start taking these screws out. Alright, so there we go. We got that piece off. So we got two 10 millimeter nuts holding this thing on, easy enough. Let's go ahead and take those off and put the new piece on. Just a quick note before you put this thing on. This piece will not fit through the hole in that shroud, so be sure to take this off first. Also, by the way, you can buy just this piece if that's all you're missing, but this was broke on mine, so that's why I got the whole thing. Alright, so final touch, we got to put this guy back on. It just slips right over this, just like that. So when you pull this back, it just pushes that thing back ever so slightly. So when you got the target top out and it's stored back here, it clips into place right here. So for any of you guys who may be new to C4 or maybe you've never been inside of a C4, the target top feature is very different from C5, 6, and 7. It's actually quite a bit more difficult to get the target top out of the car. You know, in C5 and newer Corvettes, you just have those two latches on the front of the windshield that you just kind of swing open, and then the one clip in the back. Well, it's not that easy in the C4. So you have this ratchet that came with the car. Even says Corvette on the handle. Oh, and I think it says it right there too. Look at that. But anyways, so you got a tool. So up behind the sun visor, there's this little hole here. That's where you insert your ratchet here. And there's a Torx bolt on this side as well as on the passenger side that hold the target top in. Surprisingly, I don't think there's anything on the rear that unclips or anything. So, yeah. All right. Project number two for today is I'm going to show you guys how to clean the L98 intake manifold. So obviously mine is still on the car. So I've actually gone ahead and bought a second intake manifold. So these things are surprisingly inexpensive on the used market. I got this one off of eBay for like $100. Surprisingly, none of the runners are dented or anything. There's a lot of them out there that have some pretty bad dings. This one's pretty dirty, but I do have plans to have this polished. So when we do eventually take that one off the car, I'm going to already have this all polished up and ready to put on the car. But today, we are just going to be cleaning it. It is aluminum. All of the pieces, there's four pieces, two runners, the upper intake manifold, as well as that back piece that covers the distributor cap. There is a lower portion of the intake manifold as well, but that is bolted to the block and to the heads. So we're not going to worry about that today. So we're just going to worry about this one. So we're going to be taking it outside and cleaning it. So once again, I'm going to be using this Napa aluminum brightener. Do make sure you wear safety glasses when using this, and I do advise to wear gloves as well. So before we go to town, let's take one last look at these things. It's actually not too bad. Here's the upper intake. We're gonna try to clean the inside as well. Interesting to see what the inside looks like. This little piece is pretty corroded up too, so. All right, let's get to work. All right, there you go. So I'd say they cleaned up pretty well. Interesting that this cover is not as bright of a like silver aluminum color as the other three pieces. But anyhow, these things are ready to go to the polisher. So that is going to do it for today. I think probably tomorrow I'm going to go get the car registered and insured. And then we'll go over all the details on how much all of that cost. That should be pretty interesting. Also, coming up, we got the whole fuel system to do. We're going to do fuel pump, fuel filter, some other stuff. I am getting all of the parts to do the power steering pump, hoses, everything that goes along with that. I am still waiting on the rear shocks. Those are on back order, so I'm not going to do the front shocks just yet. Also, I did end up ordering the wrong brakes for the car. I ended up ordering the Z51 brakes instead of the base model brakes. So I had to return those. So the correct ones should be here in a few days. So waiting on that. Otherwise, We got a lot of parts. I got boxes all over the garage. So a lot more C4 content to come. Hope you guys are enjoying it. If you are, please smash that thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. Also, don't forget to check out the merch store. Link is in the description. And we'll see you guys later. Take care.